The year 2017, I came to a small village in northern Italy. This village is Gressone La Trinite. It's only 40 families live in this village. But this village is so beautiful. On the foothill of Montelosa Peak is the ski area. All place is so beautiful. The people in a few village in this area, they are Valsa. Valsa is a tribe that they roaming to do trading between Germany, Switzerland and Italy. They are beautiful. I came here to visit Bunchan, my friend from my village. He married with Miriam, who grew up here in this village. Both of them live here for many years and they have two kids. Both of their two kids are Thai ski national team now. They are very happy family and they live in the most beautiful place that I ever seen in my life. I fell in love with the nature and the beauty of the landscape here. It's so nice and beautiful. And the way people live here are so beautiful also. Even they have a lot of income from tourists. There's a lot of tourists come here every year to play ski and enjoy the beauty of this place. But people still live in the self-reliant way quite a lot. They build their own house with rocks mainly. Even the roof of the house is rock, stone. They have so many beautiful old buildings in this area. Even some of them are wooden house. It's older than 100 years here. It's so beautiful, all their building. Even when they start to have more business, more people come. They build hotel, resort, but they still have their own character. It looks very unique to come and see this place. Many families still have a small garden behind their house or next to the house. They have their own vegetable food here. They have a lot of cows. They have cows more than population of people in the village here. They make unbelievable cheese here. There are many kinds of cheese that they make by their own. So they don't need to buy milk from outside this place. Bunchan and Miriam, my friend, they donate a piece of land and this building for make a small temple for Buddhist monk. So I visit him here and he said he want to have a small kitchen. So I experiment to do adobe bricks here. It's quite cold to work in the high elevation that they have snows more than 7 months a year. So it's a lot of snow, quite cold. But it's quite fun to make bricks in the cold climate with a lot of rocks. So, but it's fun. Every morning I need to wet until 10 o'clock. Wait for the water melt because water in the bucket will freeze. So it's quite cold to work with the mud. But it's fun when you think about the beauty of this area. It looked like a heaven for me who never seen anything like this. Okay. At first, I don't know how can people get food or vegetable in the high and cold mountain like this. But actually, there are so many things to eat here. Bunchan, my friend, he taught me how to harvest wild vegetable to eat. I realized that food is everywhere if we know what is edible. This is the most yummy. This is my favorite flowers that I love to eat in this mountain. There are so many kinds of them. Some of them I know, some of them I don't know. Some of them is edible, but many of them are good medicine too, like this. Stinging nettle, I make tea from it. Wild strawberry is incredible, it's small, But the taste is good. If we pick a lot, you will get a lot from it. Some of them we don't know what is it. But some of them is very good herbs, like this one. I forgot the name in Italian name. So I enjoy picking vegetable in the high mountain. So fun. If we learn what is edible, what is not edible in each area, we will have food in everywhere. So to go back to study the wisdom, the old wisdom that people used to be in the past, is very important thing. Because food is everywhere, we just need to know how to eat and what is edible. We enjoy a lot of wild vegetable here all the time. Traveling is one part of homeschooling for my son. So he came here with us to learn the world. And then he experiment, we help to make the water heater system here. It's a good lesson for him. How can we make hot water? My friend also teach rock climbing for my son here too. He enjoy it a lot. It's very fun for kid to do different kind of sport in everywhere you go. That's the way we learn. Learning should not be in the room only. We have to be outside more than in the room. This is the natural way of learning. I think it's important for most of the kids now. Rock climbing is very fun thing for kids this age. Every year, Balsas people in this area, they will have the big gathering once a year. They have the big parade, and people dress up in their traditional dress. So beautiful. A lot of people came to visit this place because of the beauty of their tradition here. Look at those people with the nice decoration. Beautiful. There are lots of tourists all over the world come for this event specially. What impressed me the most is Bun Chan took me to a farmer market in Biola. It's about 20 minutes away from his home. This place they call Orti Della Malpenga. It's the name of the farmer market. This farmer market is organized by Association Auto Ag Quarto. This market is in Villa La Malpenga, in this castle area. They have garden, they have class for people to learn about permaculture, learn about slow food. They have a lot of workshop here. I was sucked into this market until I forgot the time. I enjoy to see different kind of cheese, bread, and many things here. There are so many different variety of things. Only potato, there are almost 20 varieties of potatoes in this area. I never seen many different kind of this potato before. They have white color, purple color, red color, many different kind of color, different kind of shape. When I walk to the area of chili pepper, I feel like I walk into the art museum of heaven. There's so many different varieties of chilies. Many of them I haven't seen it in my life. You can see different color of chili, different shape. There's so many varieties. I love to try it, but it's too many. I think next time I want to come to visit this place again. I love this farmer market a lot. I love with chilies. There are more than 20 varieties of dry beans. Many of them. I haven't seen it before too. Even apples. There's a lot of varieties of apples here. Many of them I haven't seen it too. so beautiful, and then they very good about label them, explain them. There's some people help to explain it to you, what kind of apple and how it tastes and how do we grow them. Even pear, they have many different kind of pear. I have been to many farmer market in many countries before, but here I think it's special. I can see they have so many variety of vegetable and things here. Only pumpkins, you can't imagine how many varieties they have here. So this is the most incredible place in the world. This northern of Italy, they have a lot of biodiversity. They have the best food securities in the world. If economics collapse, if we have war, if we have different kind of crisis, people here will be okay because they have local seed, local food in their hand. They have food security. They rely on themselves with their own food. So this is the most security, the most important thing in our life. I love this place. When I think about farmer in Thailand, now very few people who have seed, local seeds in their hand. Most of them rely on a few varieties from the market and from a few company. Our health, our life, our security is in the hand of a few company who can make us get sick or die or whatever. We are in their hand. Thank you for Miriam Bunjan and family who let me see that there's a real heaven on this earth. And thank you for Association Otto Accordo and the owner of the Villa La Malpenca who helped to organize this event to help farmers and to preserve biodiversity, preserve food security for people in the next generation. And they also have the workshop for many people come and learn how to make our food secure, how to live in the way that we can live in a sustainable way.